Today I will cover the section on the mechanical technology entry. Now, this section is fall under your question one, which is your power transmission. Now, you know that in your power transmission, you have a bed drive, chain drive, gear drive, coupling and clutches. So I've designed a slideshow here representing couplings. Now, the intention of this session is just to show you the structures, because if you're looking at your textbook, it only gives you the orthographic view of the couplings. So in this section, I've tried to combine the different eliminations of your couplings so that you can have more overview of how your couplings look like in practice. Now, we covered three types of couplings. Okay, before we go there, we should remember the function of a coupling. It joins your two shafts together. So this is just, in a nutshell, the function of a coupling, to join two shafts together. It falls under your power transmission because usually you join your driver shaft into a driven shaft. In other words, there's a power that is being transmitted by the shaft, which is on your motor side. It transmits power as you join it to your driven shaft. So it you join a driver to a driven shaft, and that is why it's falling under your power transmission. There are many advantages of a coupling. Transportation purposes is one of the advantages. Instead of taking one long shaft from where they design a shaft or where they manufacture a shaft to a workshop, you just cut it into equal halves, and then when you fit it in, you join it with a coupling. The other advantage is our vibration. There's a less vibration on a shorter shaft than a longer shaft. Installation purposes, it's easy to install a shorter shaft than a longer shaft. Maintenance purposes, if you're doing a maintenance, it's easier on a shorter shaft than a longer shaft. So there are many advantages or the purposes of a coupling. But the basic function is to join two shafts together. And then there are many types of a couplings. We only gonna limit it into a mechanical entry syllabus, but we have many types of a coupling. But the purpose of my presentation here is to show you the structures of a couplings, and then a little explanation when necessary. Now, we covered three types of a couplings, as you could see there. It's a fast coupling, flexible couplings, and self-aligning couplings. So these are the three types of a couplings which we cover at entry mechanical technology. Now, as you could see here, under your fast coupling, you have a solid MAF coupling, split MAF couplings, and then your flange couplings. We need to know this. So you know the three groups, and then this page show you under each groups the type of a coupling that we will cover here. And then under flexible coupling, you have a pin types, and then you have a BP types, and then your flexible tie coupling. And then the last one, on your old dam couplings, you have, under your self-aligning couplings, you have old dam, and then a universal couplings. Now, when you go into this, the first type of your fast coupling, it's called your solid MAF coupling. This is how your solid MAF coupling looks like. The one at the bottom shows you the structure that you will see if you're looking at a solid MAF coupling. They call it a solid MAF coupling. This outside part, which you see, that is cylindrical in shape. It's just one cylindrical with your inner, with your inside diameter where this shaft will fit. So you have shaft one here, and then your shaft two. This is a driver shaft and a driven shaft. This is a key. This key lock your shaft into your MAF. This outside part is called a MAF. So they call it a solid MAF coupling because this MAF is just solid, as you could see here. It's just one solid cylindrical element, and then your two shafts which fit in on an inside diameter. One shaft will fit this side, the other shaft will fit this side, and then they will meet at a center, and then they will be locked by this key. And then this key will lock your shaft into your coupling. And then it will also avoid an axial movement of this coupling. So this is just a solid mouth coupling which falls under your fast coupling. Your next coupling is called your split mouth coupling. Now, if you're looking at your split mouth coupling, you could see that this mouth can be splitted into two equal halves. This diagram can easily make you see the difference between your solid mouth coupling and your split mouth coupling. They call this a split mouth coupling because you could see that this mouths can be splitted into two equal halves, and then you put your coupling this side and the other one, they will still meet at the center. You still have a nut, your key there, which will lock your shaft into your mouth there. But your mouth can be splitted into two parts. That is why they call it your split mouth coupling. And then this type of a coupling, you could see they have a bolt here, bolt and nut. This bolt and nut, because this one can be splitted into two, when you join these two mouths together, you lock them with your bolt and nut, these three bolts that you can see. So this is split mouth coupling, this, and it still falls under your fast coupling. The last one, another fast coupling, is called your flange coupling. This flange coupling, now, they call it a flange coupling because you have these two flanges. This is your flange one and your flange two. Your flange one will have your shaft number two, assuming it's a driven shaft. So one flange will have a shaft fitted on this flange, this side, and then you have this other flange with a shaft which will enter the side inside the hub. So once you fit in these two shafts, you join these flanges, you lock them with your bolt and nut. You can see here's a bolt there, here's a nut which lock this bolt. So this bolt join these two flanges together. And then these flanges hold two shafts. And once they are joined together, that means you have joined your shaft one and shaft two through these flanges. So they call it a flange coupling taken from these two flanges that you could see here. So, and they still also have your key and your keyways, because you want to lock your shaft into your hub there. So that is just a function of your key. So there's two basic functions of a key. It's avoiding an axial movement of your shaft. It also lock your shaft into a flange there. So this is called a flange coupling, and it still fall under your fast coupling. The next coupling that we can study now, it's your flexible coupling. Now, you have a pin type flexible coupling as the first one. It falls under a flexible coupling. The name speaks for itself. Now, if you look carefully, sorry for that, the pin type flexible coupling is just an upgrade of your flange coupling, because you still have these two flanges. If you look at the structure, there's this flange one and flange two. Now, how will you see that it's a pin type flexible coupling? There is this, there on your pins, you have something which looks like a wrapper. You could see that this pin has a wrapper. So this is still more like your bolt and nut, but it has a wrapper. They call it a pin. This is a wrapper that will absorb the misalignment, because we use a pin type flexible coupling where there will be a misalignment of your shaft. So your shaft will not be exactly aligned. And then the function of this wrapper that you could see is to absorb all this flexibility. It allows the flexibility of your shaft. So it allows a misalignment. We use the fast coupling that we've studied first, where your shaft will be exactly aligned, where it is impossible to have any misalignment. And then a flexible coupling, it accommodates some of a misalignment. And then those misalignment would be absorbed by this rubber. So the function of this rubber that you can see is to absorb some of the misalignment. And the design is the same as your flange coupling. There are two flanges joined together by this bolt and nut, and then you have shaft one, shaft two, you have your key which lock your shaft with your flanges. So it's called a pin-tap flexible coupling. Other type of a pin-tap flexible coupling, it has a rubber band, but we won't go into details on that. You will see from your textbook there, because you have a one with another washer and then one with a rubber band, and the function of those rubber band is to absorb some of the misalignment. The next type of a coupling is your BB type flexible coupling. Now, this type of a coupling, it's easy to see because it has this spring, this grease spring. As you could see, you have flange one, flange two, one shaft will enter this side to drive shaft, the other shaft will enter the other side, and then these two flanges will be joined together, meaning you have joined a driver shaft to a driven shaft. Now, there's this spring, the function of this spring is to absorb your axial and your any type of a misalignment that might take place. So this is called your BB type flexible coupling. And then this is a spring that will absorb elasticity or any movement that will take place, because you know your spring will retain its original shape. It can expand and then go back to its original shape. So it allow the misalignment. The other one uses a rubber to take misalignment. This one would use a spring to take some of the misalignment that you might see. Now, the next coupling, it you call your flexible tie coupling. This is one most suitable for most of the couplings under your flexible coupling, your flexible tie couplings. Very simple in design. You can see now this flange one where you could see that you put one shaft here and the other shaft there. They will meet somewhere at the center. Outside this flange is your rubber, as you can see. Now, this rubber, obviously, the function of it is to absorb the misalignment. It's suitable for most of the couplings, this one. Why? Because it takes any types of a misalignment. It can take parallel misalignment, angular misalignment, and then axial misalignment, obviously, to a certain degree, this type of a coupling. But it's called a flexible tie coupling, and this is how it looks like if you go into details in nail. In practice. Now, the last type or last group of a coupling, we call it a self-aligning coupling. This is still fall, if you're looking at this one, it's still fall under flexible coupling, but because it takes larger angles, we call it a self-aligning coupling. The first one, you call this one the old dam coupling. And then the old dam, this is how it looks like. One coupling, one shaft will enter this side, the other shaft will enter the other side. And then this is your slipper. It's called your slippers there. And then there's a groove of your slipper where it enters. And then you could see that this is made of a rubber to absorb some of a misalignment. If you look at, if you look carefully, even in this design, this is not straight. So it can change angles there on the other side. So it accommodates a larger misalignment, these self-aligning couplings. But this is how it looks like. Slippers at your center, and then your flange one and flange two. At your flanges, it's where your couplings enters. It's where your shaft enters. And then this is your key to lock your shaft into your flanges. And then this is called your old dam couplings. Then the last coupling is called your universal couplings. The one that you use on your motor vehicle. You call it universal joint in your motor vehicle. These couplings, if you're looking at the output shaft of your gearbox to your propeller shaft in your motor vehicle to your differential, they join your shaft from your output of your gearbox, your prop shaft, to your input of your differential using this universal coupling. It accommodates larger engines. This is called a yoke there, as you could see. And you can see that it can turn through that angle. This is the angle that I'm talking about. This is shaft one, shaft two. So this is what I'm saying. This coupling, it's related to your flexible coupling. But because of a larger engines, we're going to put it under the category of your self-aligning coupling. This is used in a motor vehicle specifically. And then this is your shaft one, shaft two. And then your yoke there at the center. So this is your universal coupling. Some of you call it a universally joint. So this is the last type of a coupling. I hope you enjoyed looking at the structures there and surely you now know how it looks like in practice. So there are many aspects that you need to cover under your couplings. I can add a video where I'm dealing with the theory itself if you're interested, but I hope this will be enough to aid your study processes as you go further to study the note under your couplings. So this was a last one, and then it's an end of the slideshow. Thank you so much for watching the video.